Hello, my name is Jason Johnson. Thank you for watching my videos. This video is on the Raptor flowchart-based programming. We're going to look at example 5.5 using the pretest loop wisely. And what we're going to do is we're going to declare a name as a string, not an integer. We're going to write enter the name of your brother or sister, enter the word done to quit the program. And so their user is going to input the name. And while the name is not equal to done, we're going to write name or input, but in this case, we're going to change it to equal on the Raptor program when we look at this. So we're going to start the program. We're going to set the variable of name to a string. We're going to enter the name of your brother or sister. We're going to tell the user to do that and enter the word done to quit. We're going to put a loop in here and we're going to say, is the name equal to done? If it is, we'll end the program. If not, we'll have whatever the name is. We'll output that to the user and then we'll enter a name again. So the same as we did here, but we're going to enter the name again here. And then it's going to loop back up again and check to see if they put done in. If they typed in done, then it'll end. If not, it'll just continue to loop around until we're finished. So let's run this. We're going to start. It's going to set the variable of name. It's going to ask us to put a name in, and let's put in Joe. It's going to output that to Joe. Then we're going to put in Jim. It's not equal to done, so it'll output that. And let's do Mary. There we go. And then next, and then now we're going to go ahead and done. So we'll write done. And since this is equal to done, and since it's equal, it will kick out and finish the program. So we had our output of Joe, Jim, Mary. It ran 18 symbols, and it would continue to loop until it saw the variable of done. So we could have put anything in there that was a string text, and it would have continued to output that to the master console or output that to the user. All right, I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, you can leave a comment below. For my students, you can email me. Hope you have a great day. Stay safe and be excellent to each other.